Hi students, welcoming you all again in another session which is on the flower arrangement. In this session we'll be understanding about different flower arrangements which are used and which are made in the hotels for various areas. So if you see, when you see a flower, your heart fills with, you know, it blooms, like the flower blooms. Similarly, in the hotels we keep flower arrangement for different areas, say in the lobby or in the guest rooms, so that the guests can also feel the same. The objectives of this session will be that after this session, the end of the session, you, the students, will be able to understand what is a flower arrangement, plus how it adds beauty to any of the area, to the interior. Plus, you will be able to understand different flowers, foliages and fillers which are used in the flower arrangement to give a desired shape. So what is a flower arrangement? When we say, it can be, if you have to define it, it can be a systematic arrangement of all the flowers, all the plant material, those green leaves that you have, plus the container, everything very, very well organized in a systematic manner will be called or termed as a flower arrangement. So wherever you keep the flower arrangement in the hotels, it adds on the beauty. You must remember, you must have seen flower arrangements in different areas. For example, if you have visited any of the hotel, you must have seen it in the lobby. So this is kept to create the attention, to focus of the audience, or you can say the focus of the customer or guest that we have in the hotels. So what is flower arrangement? We have discussed. This is the art. I must want to say, and every time I say this, that flower arrangement, though you have certain principles to it to make, as every game has certain principles and rules, but yes, obviously the flower arrangement entirely depends upon the creativity of an individual. So areas where flower arrangement are used in hotel, it can be in the lounge, can be in the reception, on the reception desk, maybe in the center of the lobby. Your guest rooms, if you have VIP rooms, suite rooms, there also we can keep a flower arrangement. These are some of the flowers, common flowers which are used for the flower arrangement. So rose, you must have seen. We also have lilies. Again, this is available in various shades and colors. The third picture that you can see is gladioli. This is a single stick or single stem which has flowers in the vertical shape and vertical direction. This is again available in the market with the florist shops. Usually you can get these. Again, these are available in various colors and shades. Other flower is lavender. So again, this is a stick which is available. Carnations, you have different colors, different shades are available. Then you have orchid, the beautiful flower. In this picture, you can see the first picture is anthurium. This is again used in the flower arrangement, but not too many. Max 2 to 3 flower stems can be used. Other flower which you can see on the screen, it is chrysanthemums. Again, the color variation shades are available. Third picture is bird of paradise. This is one of the most expensive flower which you can say, or which you get in the market. The single stick or 2 or 3 is sufficient depending upon the style that you are going to make for the flower arrangement. Some other add-ons are daisies, you have tulips and dahlias. Again, these are with various different variations in colors. Some foliages that we use, so all the green leaves, greenery that we add in the flower arrangement is called as foliage. Different foliage which is available is ivy, you have erica palm and cotton lavender. Most of the time, erica palm is mostly or majorly used in the flower arrangements. You also have ferns, calidium and rubus, out of which the erica palm and ferns are mostly widely used. These are some of the fillers. What are fillers then? So after you have made your flower arrangement with the flowers, different flowers and leaves, the leftover spaces or the some spaces which are left, it can be filled with these small flowers which are called as fillers. So you have baby's breath, vex flower, September flower and button chrysanthemums. Baby's breath is majorly mostly used. After you have made your flower arrangement, some of the guidelines on which how to increase the shelf life. So whenever you are making flower arrangement, you should know the purpose and the area or the location for which you are going to place it. Plus, always choose your container, your plant material, flowers, leaves accordingly. There has to be certain variations in the size, color and structure of your plant material so that it can add the beauty and the harmony to the environment. Second, most important is whenever you're starting with the flower arrangement, always start with the very tallest stem or the tallest flower which you have to keep. This gives you an idea for the height of your flower arrangement. Major, most important rule for making a flower arrangement which one should never forget is never mix the fresh flowers and the artificial flowers. These has to be separate. If you are making an artificial flower arrangement, please choose all the artificial plant material, and if you are going for a fresh one, choose all the plant material as fresh. For the next class, we'll be learning about what all equipment and material that we use for the flower arrangement. I hope this session has been useful for you and will be helping you in the future also. See you soon. We'll meet in the next session with more updates and more information. Thank you so much. Have a good day.